Yes.
Yes, sir.
So, the weight releasers, they do 4 plus 2 cuts into that. You're not going to be wiping your ass for at least 10 days. So, I'm going to be working like that. But, so, yeah, I would do that. The next one down would be regular sets of foot. But your strength would have gone up.
I see. And Mark has a special toilet saying that after wiping his ass.
Yeah, true. So, he does that, and then I'll leave it alone for 6 weeks. Right?
If they're doing it too often, too much, you can only handle it for so long.
Yeah. Too much. I find 2 workouts within 2 weeks.
Yeah.
So, yeah. 6 weeks later, yeah, maybe a different chamber, press, whatever. Then I say, okay, let's.
Guys, I've been tapped, but one guy that has probably the highest, what I call kinesiology intelligence, asked to be had because. He had people, some girl was training with us, she listened to Masters Division, he improved her PB by 16 kilos in one workout.
Right.
And on 16 kilos on your deadlift, PB is a lot. And I said, why do you think? She goes, well, I have the hand of God, you know, coaching me. But the thing is that Ed has seen so many, there's a lot of guys who've seen a million sets of deadlifts, but there's not that many guys who've paid attention to a million.
And people freshen up their point of view by going to something. And they open their minds back up after they've been. That's why we have guests on this podcast. We don't have to go to seminars. It's a seminar.
Yeah, that's right. But that's a good way to have that. They ask me, do you attend lessons? This year, I attended actually maybe about 6 meetings. For me, for my busy schedule, that's a lot. But what I prefer to do is what I call it a break between feet.
So if I don't know this guy, that's something, and I call him up, actually. I'm going to be in Sacramento
with other experts. You know, before, I was not big in self-promotion, but now I realize that a lot of people are ready to help me out because of, you know, I'm teaching a seminar for executives in Australia, and it's a very expensive seminar. So the person turns to guys who make a lot of money, they want to make their lives easier. What supplements for sleep, what supplements for the brain, blah, blah, blah. It's a private seminar. And then it turns out that one of the guys said, hey, I've offered bodyguard services for all these employees.
Oh, man, 4.5 minutes into this video and I finally start talking. What's up, everyone? It's your boy, Andy Coach George Calioris. I hope that you had the volume turned up. You could hear some of Charles Poliquin. If you don't know who he is, you better get yourself learned. He's kind of a very extremely well-known coach in the strength world, in the conditioning world, in the Olympic lifting world. Not just Olympic lifting, but like Olympics, like the games itself. I wanted to leave you guys all that audio on so you could see just how uneventful my training can be, unexciting. How I train in a calm environment. Because I believe that if you put too much effort into one workout, not effort, but if you get too excited, too hyped up for one workout, then it's going to bleed into your next training that you shouldn't have to get it fired up for 10 sets of 10, 8 sets of 3, 4 sets of 6. You shouldn't have to get fired up for that kind of stuff. You want to save that adrenaline, that ability to get fired up for when it matters, for when you're going to hit a 1 rep max, for when you're competing. And basically, I wanted you to see how every single rep of that 10 sets of 10 looked damn near exactly the same. And that's what you're striving for all the time, so you don't get injured. You can change the grip width. You can change variables such as a pause or hold or tempo. But every rep should look exactly the same. Every single time. And that's it for right now. Thanks for watching. Check out High Elite. Check out Outlaw Laboratories. Peace.